नेक्स्ट इज फॉर कंडक्टर्स के बाद क्या है फॉर सेमीकंडक्टर्स. ये आपने डिस्कस कर लिया था कि मैथमेटिकली तो चलो ठीक है अल्फा इज ग्रेटर देन जीरो सो न्यू रेजिस्टेंस इज मोर देन प्रीवियस रेजिस्टेंस. रेजिस्टेंस इंक्रीजेस विद टेम्परेचर फॉर कंडक्टर्स फॉर मेटल्स. और उनका क्वालिटेटिव रीजनिंग क्या है इन वर्ड्स व्हाट इज द रीजनिंग. द रीजनिंग इज दैट व्हेन वी हीट अ कंडक्टर और अ वायर द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स दे बिकम एनर्जेटिक. दे स्टार्ट मूविंग विद ग्रेटर काइनेटिक एनर्जीज. दे कोलाइड मोर एंड सिंस द कॉज ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस इज कोलिजन्स अमंग द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स रेजिस्टेंस इंक्रीजेस. So always remember this result for conductors that resistance of conductors increases with rise in temperature and decreases with fall in temperature. It is directly proportional. Second is for semiconductors. For semiconductors, let us see what is the kind of variation. It is found that for semiconductors, alpha is negative. Alpha is negative for semiconductors. So alpha negative means R2 minus R1 is less than 0 over R1 delta T of course. So R2 minus R1 is less than 0. That means R2 is less than R1. New resistance is less than previous resistance. So that means resistance of semiconductors decreases when temperature increases and vice versa. Okay, so semiconductors, they show less resistance when temperature falls on them. When heat energy, you can say, falls on them when their temperature increases. All right, how we can explain it otherwise? How can we explain it in words? You know, let us take the example of simplest semiconductor material, that is silicon. Silicon, germanium, they are the semiconductors, right? Then let us draw silicon lattice. It is having tetravalence. So bound to six silicon atoms on each side. So silicon is having this kind of tetravalence. See, this is crystal lattice of silicon. So there are two bonds here. If I draw like this, this is the arrangement. So when heat is supplied, what happens? Some bonds they break and electrons come out. And from where the electrons have come out, there the vacancy is positively charged and it is called a hole. So when a hole is created, next electron jumps to fill that vacancy. And a hole is created here. Then next electron, neighboring electron, jumps there and creating a vacancy at its site and so on. So this way, electrons and holes, a large number of electrons and holes, they become available. So many covalent bonds, they break and conduction starts. So semiconductor becomes a good conductor even at room temperature. Zero Kelvin pe a semiconductor is properly an insulator. It is purely behaving like an insulator, having no free electrons, because you can see because of completion of bonds. But when it is supplied heat or when it is kept even at room temperature, it gets sufficient heat energy so that the electron hole pairs, they become available because so many covalent bonds they break. So what are the charge carriers in semiconductor side by side? You note down, electrons and holes are the charge carriers in semiconductor. For example, what are the charge carriers in metals? We will say only free electrons. Free electrons are the charge carriers in metals. But in semiconductors, electrons and holes are the charge carriers responsible for conduction. Okay, same way in electrolytes, what are the charge carriers? Ions. Ions are the charge carriers. Okay. So we note that for semiconductors, resistance decreases when temperature increases and vice versa. And this is the reasoning behind that. So nothing to cram. You have to just see the qualitative as well as quantitative treatment, right? So new resistance is less than previous resistance. Its resistance decreases with temperature. Third is the case with the alloys and insulators. Third is, how does the resistance of alloys and insulators vary with temperature? So for your information, their alpha is negligible, almost zero. So let's apply the formula, R2 minus R1 over R1 delta T, that is approximately zero. Or you can say R2 minus R1 is negligible, or R2 is almost same as R1. So the resistance of alloys and insulators does not change with temperature. So note this point down. The resistance of alloys does not change with temperature. Is that clear, students? Okay, so we can have a conceptual question based on this information. What is the conceptual question? It is that standard resistance coils, jo hum Ohm's law mein use karte hain, resistance boxes hote hain na, they are made up of alloys like constantin and magnanin. So write down the question. Why are standard resistance coils made up of, why are standard resistance coils made up of alloys like constantin and magnanin? ठीक है, लिख लीजिए ये क्वेश्चन. Why are standard resistance coils made up of alloys like constantin and magnanin? तो इनके क्यों बने होते हैं? Because their temperature coefficient of resistance is negligible. Their resistance doesn't change with temperature, and we want this. ठीक है, हम नहीं चाहते कि जो resistance coil हम Ohm's experiment में use कर रहे हैं to find unknown resistance, उसी का resistance change होता जाए with temperature. After some time, temperature is going to increase. तो वो अगर उसका जो unknown resistance हम assume कर रहे हैं वो fixed है. जो R हमने लगाया ना fixed resistance, वो हम assume कर रहे हैं कि fixed है. अगर वही चेंज होता जा रहा है तो हम क्या फाइंड कर रहे हैं? अननोन रेजिस्टेंस दैट वी आर गोइंग टू फाइंड शुड बी फिक्स्ड, इट शुड नॉट बी लायबल टू चेंजेस इन एक्सटर्नल कंडीशंस, राइट? सो दे आर मेड अप ऑफ एलॉय, स्टैंडर्ड रेजिस्टेंस कॉइल्स, दे आर ऑलवेज मेड अप ऑफ एलॉयस. इज दैट क्लियर स्टूडेंट्स? वेरिएशन ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस विद टेम्परेचर इज क्लियर टू यू? Resistivity we'll be doing later on. Variation of resistivity with temperature we'll be doing later on, because in that case drift velocity has to be considered, and we have not covered yet. But before that, let us do very interesting topic, superconductors. Superconductors. Have you ever heard of superconductors? Can you give any example of a superconductor? Yes. Anyone can give me any example of superconductor? Suna hai kabhi naam aapne superconductor ka? Yes. Anyone has heard the name? Gitesh is not there today. Harsimar, aapne suna hai? Chaliye. Mercury, for example, mercury, and not at all temperatures, at a particular temperature only a conductor behaves like a superconductor. For example, mercury behaves like a superconductor at 4.2 Kelvin. So note it down. This temperature is called critical temperature. Now, superconductor, what does it mean? We just did that the resistance of a conductor increases with increase in temperature and decreases with decrease in temperature. Decrease in temperature means we are cooling a conductor now. हम एक conductor को cool कर रहे हैं, और क्या हो रहा है, उसका resistance कम होता जा रहा है. तो हम cool करते जा रहे हैं, उसका resistance कम होता जा रहा है. एक ऐसा low temperature आएगा जहां पे resistance कम होते होते zero हो जाएगा. So it will not be experiencing any resistive force, any opposition, and that conductor will become a superconductor. And the temperature, that very low temperature at which this will happen, that will be called a superconductor. उसको हम superconductor बोलें, ठीक है? तो समझ में आया अब? तो ये variation of resistance with temperature से ही related है. that when we cool a conductor to a temperature below its critical temperature, then it does not experience any resistance and it becomes a superconductor. ठीक है, लिखिए definition, superconductor. When a conductor is cooled to a temperature, when a conductor is cooled to a temperature below its critical temperature, when a conductor is cooled to a temperature below its critical temperature, it does not experience any resistance. It does not experience any resistance and it becomes a superconductor. ठीक है, अब ये बहुत सरप्राइजिंग सा लग रहा है. रेजिस्टेंस जीरो होने का मतलब क्या है कि इलेक्ट्रॉन्स वॉन्ट बी कोलाइडिंग विद ईच अदर. अगर रेजिस्टेंस जीरो है, कॉज ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस इज कोलिजन अमंग द इलेक्ट्रॉन, दैट मींस इलेक्ट्रॉन्स जो हैं वो कोलाइड ही नहीं करेंगे. हाउ इज इट पॉसिबल, है ना? आपकी क्लास में दो राइवल्स हैं और वो बिल्कुल फ्रेंड्स बन गए, ऐसे कैसे हो गया, है ना? तो इसमें क्या है, थ्री साइंटिस्ट टुगेदर गेव द रीजन फॉर सुपर कनेक्टिविटी, बीसीएस थ्योरी. Its cause is famous in the form of BCS theory. Otherwise, many theories they came forward regarding the reason of superconductivity. कि ऐसा कैसे हो गया कि electrons collide ही नहीं कर रहे हैं आपस में बिल्कुल. So there were three scientists, Bardeen, Cooper, and Schrieffer. They together gave this theory. They said that at very low temperature, the electrons, they become so inert, so passive, mutually dependent and cooperative. So in place of colliding with each other, they move together without colliding. So this way the conductor becomes a superconductor. So they assume that as the temperature decreases, the electrons, they start becoming passive. They lose their kinetic energy. Unki kinetic energy kam hoti jati hai. और बहुत ही कम टेम्परेचर पे, क्रिटिकल टेम्परेचर पे क्या होता है, दे बिकम म्यूचुअली डिपेंडेंट, कोऑपरेटिव. ठीक है, एंड इन प्लेस ऑफ कोलाइडिंग विद ईच अदर, दे मूव टुगेदर इन ग्रुप्स. तो वो बिल्कुल भी कोलाइड नहीं करते. तो दैट्स व्हाई द कंडक्टर टर्न्स इनटू अ सुपर कंडक्टर. ठीक है, फॉर एग्जाम्पल मर्करी at 4.2 Kelvin, अगर आप इसको सेल्सियस में कन्वर्ट करो तो माइनस समथिंग डिग्री सेल्सियस होगा. सो इट्स क्वाइट अ लो वैल्यू ऑफ टेम्परेचर. ठीक है, सो दिस इज द प्रॉब्लम विद सुपर कंडक्टिविटी, दैट सुपर कंडक्टिविटी अकर्स एट वेरी वेरी लो डिग्रीज ऑफ सेल्सियस, वेरी वेरी लो टेम्परेचर, दैट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू जनरेट एट द लैब लेवल. एट द प्रैक्टिकल लेवल दिस टेम्परेचर इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू जनरेट. ठीक है, तो क्या किया गया, साइंटिस्ट दे आर एक्सप्लोरिंग हायर एंड हायर क्रिटिकल टेम्परेचर. दिस इज द प्रॉब्लम विद सुपर कंडक्टिविटी, बिगेस्ट प्रॉब्लम. सो दे आर ट्राइंग टू इंक्रीज द टेम्परेचर, क्रिटिकल टेम्परेचर, एंड दे हैव गॉट सक्सेस अप टू 125 केल्विन. यहां तक सक्सेस अचीव कर लिया है, बट स्टिल इट इज वेरी लेस, अभी भी ये बहुत कम है. ठीक है, तो आप इसको -273 करिए, अभी भी ये बहुत कम डिग्री सेल्सियस है. 4.2 केल्विन तो बहुत ही कम है, है ना? तो उसको कैसे जनरेट करें. अदरवाइज सी द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ सुपर कनेक्टिविटी इज सो सो यूजफुल, इट फाइंड सो मेनी एप्लीकेशंस. सो व्हाट आर द मेन एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ सुपर कंडक्टर्स, मेन एप्लीकेशंस इज लॉसलेस पावर ट्रांसमिशन, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. अगर हम कहीं सुपर कंडक्टर्स को यूज कर लें फॉर ट्रांसमिशन ऑफ पावर, फॉर ट्रांसमिशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, so it will be exactly power lossless. Power loss bilkul bhi nahi hoga. Daily new and new ways are invented to reduce the power losses while the electricity is transmitted over the wires. AC use karni chahiye, DC use karni chahiye, high voltage pe transmit karna chahiye ki low voltage pe transmit karna chahiye. Agar hum super conductors use kar le to ye lossless power transmission hogi. Theek hai, so yeah, it's a very very important use. It's a burning topic of research. Next thing is, it is a burning topic of research. It's very very important issue on which research can be done, and it is being done. Third is maglev technology. Maglev, suni aapne, magnetic levitation technology, trains that run above the rails without any contact, so they are also based on superconductivity. And then next is supercomputers. Supercomputers of future, they are believed to be based on superconductivity as well. So these are the applications. And you know, if once the current is set up in a superconducting loop, suppose आपके पास एक ऐसी वायर है, superconductor की वायर है, और उस लूप में once you set current, it will flow forever. ठीक है, जैसे वैक्यूम में अगर हम फैन को चला दें तो वो बंद भी करते तो भी चलता रहेगा ना, वैसे ही सुपर कंडक्टिंग लूप में अगर एक बार हम करंट सेटअप कर दें, इट विल गो ऑन फ्लोइंग फॉर एवर. ठीक है, सो सुपर कंडक्टर्स फाइंड सो मेनी एप्लीकेशंस, बट व्हाट इज द मेन हिंड्रेंस इन देयर पाथ, आई हैव टोल्ड यू, दैट इज द लो वैल्यू ऑफ क्रिटिकल टेम्परेचर, दैट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू अचीव. So I hope the concept of superconductors is also clear to you. So sometimes this kind of graph is asked, that which phenomena is being shown here. आप अभी तो नहीं, ये sample papers में you will find this graph. ऐसा graph है 4.2 Kelvin के ऊपर, 4.2 Kelvin पे ये zero resistance show रहा है ना यहाँ पे. ये जीरो रेजिस्टेंस शो हो रहा है 4.2 केल्विन पे, सो दैट मींस दिस फिनोमिनन इज सुपर कंडक्टिविटी, दैट रेजिस्टेंस इज बिकमिंग जीरो एट अ पर्टिकुलर टेम्परेचर. सो दिस ग्राफ इज शोइंग सुपर कंडक्टिविटी. तो सैंपल पेपर्स में आप देखोगे कुछ क्वेश्चंस बाद में, व्हेन यू विल डू योर होल सिलेबस. ठीक है, चलिए, सो सुपर कंडक्टर्स आर ओवर. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद ड्रिफ्ट वेलोसिटी. द टॉपिक ऑफ ड्रिफ्ट वेलोसिटी, दैट इज new for you. Drift velocity denoted by VD. Drift velocity. अब ये drift velocity क्या होती है? Suppose we have a conductor, we have a wire. ठीक है? It's connected across a cell or a battery having potential difference V. All right. Now, what is inside the conductor? Electrons as well as positive charges are there. Now, when we will apply this potential difference, electrons, they will start moving towards the positive plate. They will get attracted towards the positive plate. And positive charges, they will experience a force towards the negative plate. So they will start moving towards the negative plate under the attraction, because they will each experience a force F is equal to QE. Itna force experience karenge, right? Ab kya hoga ki they will go on colliding also with each other. So itni large acceleration jo hum expect kar rahe hain, acceleration, you know, F over M होता है and F is equal to QE है यहाँ पे. ठीक है, अगर हम electrons की बात करें तो Q is E, charge on electron को E symbol से denote करें, तो acceleration will be E E by M. This will be the acceleration, but we can't expect all the electrons, all the positive charges to be accelerating so much, as the depending upon the intensity of electric field that is applied. Uska reason kya hai? Because they will go on colliding with each other. So on average, their velocities will get cancelled, and on average, they will acquire only a small constant velocity with which they will drift, they will drag towards the opposite plate. So that constant velocity with which an electron gets accelerated or gets drifted towards the positive plate on application of a potential difference, that is called drift velocity. So, jitna large force is pe act kar raha hai, utne extent ki velocity ya acceleration isme produce nahi hogi on because of collisions among the electrons and other charges. So, on average, it will gain a small drift velocity. Itni small, 10^-5 m/s ke order ki ho. ठीक है, drift velocity ka order note kar lijiye. और अप्रोक्सीमेटली 10^-5 m/s के ऑर्डर की होगी. तो ऑन एवरेज एक स्मॉल सी वेलोसिटी वो एक्वायर कर लेंगे, जिससे वो धीरे धीरे ऑपोजिट प्लेट की तरफ जाएंगे, फ्रॉम वन एंड ऑफ द कंडक्टर टू द अदर एंड एंड कवर द लेंथ एल. ठीक है, सो लिखिए डेफिनेशन ड्रिफ्ट वेलोसिटी की, लिख लो, द कॉन्स्टेंट constant velocity with which electrons drift towards, constant velocity with which the electrons drift towards the opposite plate, with which electrons drift towards the opposite plate on the application of potential difference. On the application of potential difference, that is called drift velocity. That is called drift velocity. ठीक है, तो चलिए हम इसका एक्सप्रेशन फाइंड आउट करते हैं. सो सपोज देर आर एन इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन दिस मेटल, इन दिस कंडक्टर. सो व्हाट इज द वेलोसिटी गेन्ड बाय ईच इलेक्ट्रॉन, लेट अस फाइंड इट आउट. फर्स्ट, इन द एब्सेंस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड, लेट्स टॉक अबाउट व्हेन द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड वॉज एब्सेंट, वी हैड नॉट कनेक्टेड द बैटरी. इफ इट वॉज जीरो, देन यू मस्ट बी इट्स एवरेज थर्मल वेलोसिटी. So average thermal velocity of all the electrons must be zero in the absence of electric field. क्योंकि जो thermal velocities हैं वो random directions में. तो जब तक हमने electric field apply नहीं किया है वो cancel out हो जाएंगे. So average thermal velocity will be zero. Let us call it equation number one. Now we have applied the field. Now we have connected the battery. ठीक है. So when electric field is present, each of the electron is experiencing some velocity as I discussed. So let us say what is the velocity of first electron. V is equal to u plus a t. We are using acceleration is let us assume constant here. So second electron will have this velocity, and so on. Nth electron will have this much final velocity. So what is the average final velocity that we call drift velocity? Is their average v1 plus v2 so on up to vn divided by n, putting in the values u1 plus at1 plus u2 plus at2 plus so on un plus atn divided by n. Let us separate u's together, u1 plus u2 so on up to un divided by n plus a common, t1 plus t2 so on tn divided by n. Is this step clear? Koi doubt hai to pooch lo. This is tn. Theek hai. Now from equation number 1 this term is zero, average of thermal velocities is zero, and acceleration is e by m, we have already written. So drift velocity becomes zero. Plus put the value of acceleration e by m, and what do we call this term? This is average of all the times that the electrons are taking. We call it relaxation time tau. So where tau is average time, what is tau? That is relaxation time. So we get the expression for drift velocity finally e tau by m. So note down, this is the expression for drift velocity e tau by m. We will be defining relaxation time. Aap pehle likh lijiye isko and see if you have any doubts. Theek hai. So what is the formula of drift velocity? e tau by m. Learn this formula. So what is relaxation time? Relaxation time is the time taken by electron between two successive collision, or this is the time after which next collision will occur. Likh lijiye relaxation time. It is the time taken by an electron between two successive collisions. नेक्स्ट कोलिजन कितने टाइम के बाद होने वाली है, दैट इज रिलैक्सेशन. सो इट इज टाइम टेकन बाय एन इलेक्ट्रॉन बिटवीन टू सक्सेसिव कोलिजन्स, और इट इज द टाइम आफ्टर विच नेक्स्ट कोलिजन विल टेक प्लेस, राइट. सो इट इज डिनोटेड बाय सिंबल टाउ. So have a look at the whole derivation of drift velocity once. Yes. Have a look. Is it clear? Derivation clear आपको? कोई doubt है तो पूछ सकते हो students. Yes, you can raise hand if you have any doubts. No doubts. But now, a relation between current and drift velocity. Now, let us derive relation between current and drift velocity. I और VD में बहुत ही famous relationship है, ठीक है? I और VD में there is very famous relationship. तो वो हम करने जा रहे हैं, relation between current and drift velocity. ठीक है, चलिए. So first of all, again we are having a conductor across which we have applied a potential difference. There is a T as well. A is the area of this area of cross section of this conductor. B is the potential difference. E is the electric field applied, and you know one electron is suppose drifting with the drift velocity Vd towards the opposite plate. तो एक इलेक्ट्रॉन जो है वो ड्रिफ्ट कर रहा है टुवर्ड्स द ऑपोजिट प्लेट. ठीक है, ये इलेक्ट्रॉन ले लिया हमने, राइट. तो अब आई इज इक्वल टू बेसिकली क्यू बाय टी. सो वी आर टू फाइंड चार्ज. लेट एन बी नंबर डेंसिटी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन द कंडक्टर. लेट एन बी number density of electrons. Number density means number of electrons per unit volume. Number of electrons per unit volume, that is number density. So how many electrons are there? What is the number of electrons then? So number of electrons will be n multiplied by volume. N multiplied by volume of the conductor. ठीक है, तो अब वॉल्यूम को आप कैसे लिख सकते हो? वॉल्यूम को यू कैन राइट एरिया इनटू लेंथ. व्हेन एरिया इज गिवन एंड लेंथ इज गिवन, वी कैन राइट वॉल्यूम ऑफ कंडक्टर ऑफ एनी शेप एज एरिया इनटू लेंथ. सो दिस इज हाउ वी हैव फाउंड द नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. नाउ क्यू इज इक्वल टू एन ई. क्यू होता है नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इंटू ई. नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स अभी हमने निकाल लिया, एन ए एल. सो दिस इज द चार्ज वी विल बी पुटिंग इन इक्वेशन नंबर वन. तो हमने पहले चार्ज निकाल लिया कंडक्टर के ऊपर इन टर्म्स ऑफ इट्स नंबर डेंसिटी. तो एक तो ये पुट करेंगे टाइम. नाउ व्हाट इज द टाइम दैट द इलेक्ट्रॉन टेक्स टू ड्रिफ्ट फ्रॉम वन एंड ऑफ द कंडक्टर टू द अदर एंड. टाइम इज डिस्टेंस. डिस्टेंस कितना है जो उसने लेंथ कवर की कंडक्टर की, ओवर इट्स वेलोसिटी. और कितनी वेलोसिटी से इलेक्ट्रॉन जा रहा है दूसरी प्लेट की तरफ? ड्रिफ्ट वेलोसिटी से जा रहा है. So we have found time also. Now let us put both the things in equation number one. So hamara I ban gaya N A L E upon L by V D. L gets cancelled. So we are left with I is equal to N A E V D. So this is very famous relationship between current and drift velocity noted down. हम इसको कैसे लर्न करते हैं? A N V D. A N E A N V D. So I is equal to A N V D. ऐसे हम बोलते हैं. So you can also memorize this relationship accordingly. I is equal to A N V D. ठीक है, देख लीजिए ये डेरिवेशन, हैव अ लुक, इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट्स यू कैन टेल मी। चलिए ठीक है, कोई डाउट है तो पूछ लो बच्चे। सो दिस इज द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन करंट एंड ड्रिफ्ट वेलोसिटी। टुमारो वी विल बी डूइंग मोर आर्टिकल।